Hi everyone, I'm Shaylin here with Reedsy. Today I'm going to be talking about common short story mistakes and cliches. So this is a follow-up to our video on Tuesday where I talked about how to start a short story. I love talking about short stories because I love short stories. So today I wanted to talk about some common mistakes, many of them being mistakes that I have made myself. Just very common things that crop up a lot when people are just starting to learn how to write short stories. So the first one is a plot line that just features characters wandering around or sitting around talking. It can be kind of a hard hurdle to get over at the start, but it's important to remember that two people just sitting in a room talking isn't a story. Even if your story is going to revolve around the interaction or conversation between two characters, give them something to do rather than just having them sit around, because that's not a story. They could go hunting, they could be vandalizing their prior workplace, they could be organizing a rich bibliophile's personal library by the Dewey Decimal System because they were hired to do this as a side job because they needed some extra cash. As soon as you give them something to do, it immediately makes the situation way more interesting and it can actually become a story. You have details to play with, you have setting, you have way more conflict, and you can also start to set up symbols this way. Number two would be trying to do too much. This is a common error for writers who are coming from the long form, who've been writing novels, and then try writing short stories. If you're used to writing very long pieces, you might not really know what a short story feels like. You don't really know what a short idea is. And so it can be a very common error to simply take on too much, have too many characters, want to write a story that spans over a very long period of time, when ideally a short story is probably only going to have a couple characters, and it's probably only going to center around one event. There are always exceptions, you know, there are writers like Austin Rowe who have these giant casts in their short stories. But when you're just getting started, try not to do what you would do in a novel. The novel exists for a reason, and that's to tell a very big story. And the short story exists for a reason, and that's to tell a short story. So try to tell that short story, pare it down to as few characters as you can. When in doubt for your first story, I would recommend just starting with two characters. A lot of short stories can function perfectly well and support themselves on just two characters, and you won't risk the story getting overcrowded. And similarly to that is making it way too long. I've noticed that as I learned to write short stories over the span of several years, and that's that my stories got shorter and shorter and shorter and shorter. And when I look at all my old stories when I was just learning how to write short stories, they're all a couple thousand words too long. They have more scenes than they need, the scenes are a little bloated because I was writing novel scenes. I was writing these big novel type scenes. And there were all these extraneous details because I was trying to develop the character like I would for a novel. And the more I wrote short stories, the more they started to get pared back and all the unnecessary fluff and detail kind of got shed. And I think that when in doubt, usually a short story is better when it's more efficient. If you're coming from a background where you write novels, it might be your impulse to write longer stories that are 6,000, 8,000, 10,000 words. But challenge yourself to try writing a 4,000 word story and see what you can accomplish in that amount of space, because you can probably accomplish more than you think you can. The next error is one that I definitely did. It was actually one of my biggest problems when I was just starting out, and that's withholding too much. In the first short story I ever wrote, the biggest problem with it structurally was kind of that I structured it how you would structure a thriller, where most of the information was kind of kept off the table, and then everything important was kind of revealed at the very end of the story, almost like a big reveal, a big plot twist. But readers are only investing in this for a very short amount of time, and if they're gonna spend 15 out of 16 pages being confused about what's even happening and why everything is important, it's not going to be a very enjoyable story. That draft of that story was really only interesting on the last page or the last couple pages, because that's when we realized why the story was relevant. So if you have important information, don't be afraid to just share it from the beginning. It's better to have a reader who understands what's important and what's at stake than have a story that's hard to invest in just for a big reveal later. Oftentimes with short stories, they're so short that it's not really about the mystery of what happens, it's more about how we get there. The next biggest mistake is something I talked about a little in the last video, and it's a boring title or first sentence. Now, these things aren't crucial. There are good stories out there that don't have a strong title or don't have a strong first sentence. But having those things be strong and interesting can be a huge advantage when you're submitting your story to magazines. Even more important in a short story than in a novel, that you have a really strong first sentence to grab an editor's attention, grab a reader's attention, in order to draw them into the story as quickly as possible. Because the story is so short, you also don't have a lot of time to really pull people into it. Same goes for the title. Why pass up the opportunity to really capture a reader's attention with a great title and just go for something kind of lackluster? And finally, would be choosing a protagonist who doesn't have an interesting perspective. Again, because a short story is so short, with a protagonist, you really want to reveal something interesting about that character throughout the story. If not, the story doesn't really pack a punch. You don't have much space, so you really want to choose someone who can provide a very specific, interesting view of the world. Choosing a main character who's kind of blank and has a bit of a boring perspective on the events isn't doing you a lot of favors. That character isn't really a very worthy protagonist. Don't be afraid to make them a little weird, to make them a little bizarre, to make their voice a little strange. Short story is the best time to play around with that because you don't have to carry it for a very long period of time. So those are a couple common short story mistakes. Many, if not all, that I have made myself. Thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss any new videos from us. We've got new writing, publishing, and editing tips every Tuesday and Friday. Until next time.